I am joined by Marlene McNutt of Fire Mountain Gems and Beads. And you know, Marlene, you're so talented. You always teach us great things. And today, you're going to be telling us about some great finishing techniques, correct?
Yes, I am.
Okay, so two things that we're going to be talking about. First of all, these necklaces, what do they all have in common? What finishing techniques were used here?
These necklaces are all finished with French wire or bullion.
Okay. So how do you actually do that, and what is that?
Actually, it's a very fine wire that's tightly coiled into a tube shape.
So are these examples of them here?
These are examples. Okay. They're all hollow inside. They come in different finishes. There's gold and silver plate, as well as sterling silver and gold filled.
Now, are they hollow? Because they look just like chain, or, I mean, they just...
They do resemble chain, but they are completely hollow. They're shaped like a tube.
Oh, okay. Interesting. And then they come packaged like that.
They come packaged in a 15-inch section. And then you just cut the piece according to whatever you're going to do with your design, whether you're finishing onto the clasp or whether you're actually using it in your design. Okay. And just cut the length that you need.
Now, what would be the purpose of using something like this?
French wire is used basically in two different purposes. One is that it keeps your stringing material from being abrasive against metal,
like
the beads or the clasp.
Yes.
But then it also covers your finishing material so that it blends in with your clasp.
So you could use any color of cord that you wanted to, because you know you can put that over it. Oh, that's great.
Yeah.
Now, can you show me how to do that?
Sure.
Incorporate it?
What we've done here is we have cut these sections and we've actually used them in the design of the necklace.
Wow.
So these are movable. They just slide back and forth on the thread.
That is amazing how it doesn't look at all like it's hollow. Like it looks like that's just gold, you know?
It does. Mm-hmm. Yes, it's a very nice, it's a complement to a lot of different beads and gemstones.
Okay, so you cut the sections.
So we cut the sections, and then at the attachment where you're going to hook it actually to the clasp, you want to use just a short piece. You don't need to use a very long piece at all. Basically, what you want it to do is to just cover the thread and just enough length to where it covers the loop on your clasp.
Okay.
You need to center it.
Okay.
And then as you tighten, as you see, it forms a small loop.
Look how flexible it is, too.
It's very flexible.
Yeah, that's wonderful. So you're not limited.
You're not
limited
at all.
First I'm thinking, is it flexible?
Yes.
Perfect. Oh, that looks terrific.
So it just makes a very nice way to finish your piece off.
Now, do you have another finishing technique for us today?
We do. We have bead tips.
Okay.
And as you can see, I brought a good selection with me. We have some new designs out now.
So here's some examples of them here.
Yes.
Okay. Different colors I see as well.
Different colors. They also come in the plated gold and silver and in sterling silver and gold filled.
Okay. Now, how would you use those?
These are used basically the same. It's a finishing, a more classy finishing technique.
We like that.
We like that, yes.
Are there particular stones that it's mostly used with, or you can use it just at any time?
You will mostly see bead tips used on pearl strands. The pearls are knotted.
That makes sense, yeah.
So it works that way.
Okay, all right. Show me how to work it.